Any questions? Shall we start?
Back.
I don't know. I think they are trying to do something. Than 16 highlight that value. So you can, it's a default value is red, light red filled with the dark red text. So here it's a light red with dark red text styles. If you wish, we can modify that value also. Just come to the greater than values. I will set it as 80 and just press this drop down, and you can choose default values, the yellow fill with dark yellow, or you can choose green or light red, such a way, or you can use a custom format. Mostly custom format is you can create your own idea. So I will press the custom format. So I will set something. I need the bold. I can set the border also. So I will set the border such as this way, this border for the outline, then fill with the yellow. So I will choose this type of, choose the bold, bold and italic, then border, then fill, I will press OK, then press OK. This custom format is applied for this condition. This condition is what are the things are greater than 80 between these values, and I set some my custom formatting. Then I back to the here, you can set as a less than or between. So between means between the values. I will choose the between. Here we can set the minimum and maximum values between the values. I will set 22, 60. I will set it such a way, and here also you can set your custom formatting, or you can select your default values such a way. So this is also one of the way to conditional formatting. So here they are providing the between equal to text that takes the contents. So next one is top bottom rules. So top bottom rules means we need to top to bottom value. We can set the top to bottom values. Just wait a minute. Just, I'm sorry for the disturbance. Just go to the top to bottom rules. Just I press the top to bottom rules. I will set it as 5 values. So 5 values and 6 values, it means it's going to align what are the things as a top values. So based on here, we can align this value. For example, 20, 25, 36, 60. Such a way it's going to align and providing the what are the top 6 values or top 3 values. I will choose the top 3 values. What are the top 3 values? 100, 99, 80. That's another top 3 values. We can choose such a this way also. Or you can find out the percentage, or you can choose the bottom values means the, what are the lowest value. For example, what are the bottom 3 values. I will choose the bottom 3 values or 2 values. Is 20 and 25 are the bottom values are here. So you can set a format such a way also. Next value is the data bar. Data bar means based on our values, it's going to providing a data bar. It's look like a bar chart. It's look like a bar chart, but not a bar chart. It's such a this way. It's providing value based on the values and chart. Here you can view this way. So you can simply select this part and you can set it data bar. So you can choose your more rules. If you can define your rules and you can set it your based on your rules. So I can set means I will undo this values. You can set the icon also. So first one is a condition base and highlighting. The next one is the data bar. Next, another one is the color scale. So color scale means it's like a between the red to green or red to yellow, something like. So high prefer point out the green color and low print low priority is a red color. Between the values are come to the this format. So between the green and yellow, or you can set any some your custom color also. I choose the more rules and I can choose the lowest value and I will set the number here. I will set it as lowest. Minimum number is 20. I will choose my color such a way yellow. Highest value is a number I will type is 100. This color will be red. Okay, my maximum color want to show the red color, minimum color want to show what's the yellow color. I will set. Okay, so here you can simply view red color means maximum, 20 is a minimum color means yellow. Between the values it's providing the it's a based on the ratio, color ratio, it's changed to yellow to red to yellow. That's another format, a conditional format. So next option is you can simply define your rules also. Here based on your rules you can set the number or percentage of formulas. So percentage means you can set the percentage values. For example, 10% or 20, that's based on your ideas. There are some other only for the some cells, or you can set the top to bottom ranking, where you can modify your own ideas. So next option is icon states. So icon states is better to the identify the marks sheet. So based on here, I will choose this option. So 100 means the top 220 is a very low. So such a way it's providing an icon for the providing the condition, or you can set your own condition. Here you can provide any value, any icons, or you can use more rules, and you can define your own ideas. So here minimum value means maximum value is 67, below the 67. Above the 67. Between the 67 and 33, it's going to show the yellow. Otherwise, it's going to show the red color. So I will define some new stars. Okay, I will define the stars here. So I will set 50. Above 50 means full star. 20, between 50 and 20 going to half star. 20, below 20, we don't have anything. So I will set 30. 30 to 50 is a half star, and otherwise it's an empty star. Okay, so I will set it this values. It's a, I will set it as a number because I have a number. It's a 30, it's a 50. I hope you want to try these things, then only we can manage. I will press OK here. Below the 30, it's show the empty stars. It's between the 50 and 30, it's show the half star. Otherwise, it's show the full star. So you can define your own conditions and own format here using these options. And here, here I am using the icon status only, states only. Then if I wish, I can use the bar. I will add a bar, and I can add this option also. I will choose more. I will greater than. I will set my own format here. Border such a this way. Fill with okay. Okay. Greater than 80. Actually here it's have both values. Here you can see the. So here I use three type of the conditional format. First one is this icon. Second one is the data bar. Next one is the highlight cells. So if you need clear all the rules, you can clear all the rules using this clear rules option. When I press this clear all, its rule will be clear based on your access. And you can create your own new rules. So you can create your own new rules. So your colors and values are your wish. So you can set as a number, percentage, everything here. So that's the option in conditional formatting. So that about the this option. That's all. So do you have any question for this under the this conditional formatting? Do you have any questions? Just try this part, and if you have any question, let me know. Just go to the next part, and if you wish, you can choose every cell and you can set the conditional here. Yes. Okay, so next one is a table format as a table. So table format means we can use the form here, we can use the header and title such a way. So this time we need some style for our table. So that's the option for the format as a table here. We can set it such this way. So if you wish, you can modify this everything based on your styles. So you can set format as a table. It's not that much complicated here, but one problem is it's give the some shorting option defaultly. Otherwise, you need to come to short, use this short button, short option. In this case, they are providing the short option. For example, I need the short this values based on my I want to greater than, okay, smallest to largest. I will press this option. It's going to align such a this way. Actually, this column 1, 2, 3 is come to because I choose my table such a this way. That's why it show. I will choose only this options. I will choose this format. Okay, I want to align based on largest to smallest. It's going to align. Or if you wish, you can based on this largest to smallest, you can set such a this way. One problem is you can only use one field for the alignment. It's a sorting method. Or you need to filter your values. For example, here I have 100 to 20. Okay, I need above 50 values. So above 18 values only I need to filter. Then I will choose this option. And I will go to number filter. And I will choose greater than. Here we have multiple options such as greater than or equal, less than such a way. I will choose the greater than option. I will set this value as a 80. Then I will press OK. Then it's show the what are the values have above the 80. That's values only the show in between this into the table. So that's also one of the, I will remove this option. If you wish, you can set a or condition one. For example, I will set the or condition less than value. I will set less than 30. What other things are below the 30? So it show the what other things below the 30 and above the 50. So this is also you can filter using this options, or you can set as you can use filter option here also. I will explain later. So that's about the format as a table. So you can come to the table design, then you can set your color or padding styles. That's everything into the table design. I not explain this part. And here you can look at this table style option. So table style option means sometime we need to highlight our header, or sometime we no need to the highlight. So I will untick this option. I just unhighlight our header. So sometime I need total row. Total row means below this table. So I will, I need to some tables, total table, I will set the total. It's going to define the total row and give the answer to. So next one is the banded row means, first column means, this is our first column. So if you need to highlight your first column, you can highlight your first column too. It's a last column means last column. If you need, you can use both. Banded column means one after one, such as this way. Here I will choose this option. Here, can you? Yes, you can view here. I will untick this option. Here, we need to banded column means one after the one column, such a this column, then this column, then after this column, such a this way. Banded row means one after the one column. So this column, then it's ignore this and back to the this column. That style also. So you can view here format, this format. So that's a effect for the table options. That's about only table format. So let's move to the cell style. Cell style means we already defined the table style. Cell means it's a single cell. So you can define the single cell styles here. It's just only the style, not a no, it's it don't have any conditions or such a this way. And you can use the heading or the as a Word document. You can view the Word document and you can find the heading such a this way. So you can set a heading also. I will choose this part and I will set that as a heading one. So then it's look like a heading one. Yes, it's a little bit stuck. Okay, so that's about this section. That it's have a insert. So I need to insert here. I need to insert any row or column. I will choose this cell option. I can insert column or you can add any row. I'll choose this option and you can add the row. So this is the way you can add the rows and columns. And same thing, you can delete the row and columns based on your options. You can select the column or you can select the cell. Sorry, you can select the correct cell. It's already filter cell. That's why I can't access. So I will select my cell and I will go to the delete. I can draw, delete the sheet or sorry, delete the row or column such a way. So format means here we have providing a height width. I forgot to tell that. Actually, here we can drag our height and width such a this way. You can come to the cell header and you can set the point like this. Then you press your left button and track it here. Not a right button, it's just a normal press. Right button, right click and sorry, left click, just drag here such a this way. So this is one way to you drag and drag your tables. Sometimes we need to set our height and width based on your content. For example, that's maximum level name is Vaishnavi something. Okay, Vaishnavi. Okay, that's so I need this this level of height and row is enough. So that time I will choose where is that format options. And I will set autofill draw and height and width. Draw and height. So autofit, it's a width. That's why I so autofit your column. So autofit your rows. It's based on your content. It's automatically height and width will be changes. For example, if you wish, you can use a shortcut key. Shortcut key is you come to the this point and take your mouse point such as this way. Your mouse point won't change like this. Then you press double click in left button. Then it's back to the content size here. Left click. Okay, that's one of the way to set your content based on your set your table based on your content. Or you can set here also height width and height and height visibility for that part. I want to hide this cell. I can press this option and hide this draw. So I can hide this option. Then I will come to this point. You can view this different between the 8 and 10, right? It's there one small gap. Then press right click and press unhide. Then it's going to show. I will press the unhide draw. Sorry, yes. So it's going to unhide here. Okay, that's a way to you can hide and unhide your row and columns. You can find out here and try these things using dummy values. Then you can rename the sheet name here or you can rename your sheet name. Press double click or you can press right click here and rename. Or you can here also you can rename your sheet. Tap color, that also you can set it here or you can press here and right click and tap color also you can available here also. You can product your sheet, format your sheet, lock your sheet, everything is you can do in here also. So that's all about the cell and styles. So any questions? Sorry? Okay. Let's move to the editing option, editing part. So based on this editing part, we have the formulas. So basically we are using the sum average and count numbers. These functions are usual thing. That's why it's defaultly show here. If you wish, you can press the more function and you can find out the all the function here. Or you can press this button, this function icon, and you can find out the all the function here. Just press out the function. I will explain the later in function. There are so many options are in function. So next option is let's go to the this formatting clear option. So there are I already we view some copy and paste options as same thing we have clear. So we can clear everything, or we can clear the format only, or content only, or clear comments and notes, or hyperlink. For example, okay, take this option. We have the some effect here, and we need to clear this format only. Format means need to remove this background bold and size everything. I will press this and clear format. So it's clear format. Sorry, it's a background. It's always fixed. That's the issue in Word also. Then you can remove the content. Content mean data value. So it's going to clear the value. Clear comments and notes. Comments and notes we can give the review. For example, I will give the comments for here. I will type, okay, this is a problem, or this you need to change. Then I will type, come to here and type such as this comments. So if you have any comment, it shows some this icon in top of your corner. Then I will attach some hyperlink. Hyperlinks okay. So I need to remove this comments here. So I will select this cell and back to here, and I will clear comment and notes. Then it's going to clear the comments. Then hyperlinks means we can hyperlink our text. I will quick access hyperlink. Yes, I will going to link this text to my some email address. I will type such a this way. So here it's going to hyperlink. If you have any hyperlink, it's going to underline and it shows some lighter blue color. It's default thing. So I need to clear this hyperlink, and I will click this one and right here click. You can clear hyperlink. Clear hyperlink. Here it's a format only here. So then I will clear format. It's back to the normal stage. Oh, you can clear everything. Everything means font, styles, format. So I will select this cell. Clear all means it's going to clear everything, not a table background that because this is a format we already defined it is into the format as a table. So we can't remove that format values only. So I will press the clear all. So next one, find. So here, find replace go to means okay. Find we can show find yeah here find and replace. Find means we need to using some keywords current folder. So we can find using some keyword and find out in our whole page. For example, I will type Madhu. I can find Oh, you can replace such any word. I will type XXX and I will replace. Or you can press replace all also. Replace all means it's going to find all the word what other things have in Madhu. Then it's going to replace such a XXX. So that's a way to replace and find. Then you can go means you need to identify only. So that is the option. Next one is a select object. Select object means if you add some images or icons, sometimes we cannot click or we cannot access that options because of the data. If you need to click only the object, you can press select object only. Okay, then you can select the object. For I will add some image here. Now I will okay. So in such a way, I will select this select object. Then I will click this option. If I click other things, I can't access anything. It's only we can select the object only. So that's the purpose of object select. Okay. So just go through these things, and if you have any question, let me know. Let ask me.
Kumar ma, mangala vegalunga. இங்க நிக்கிற லங்கல போய் கேளுங்க
சோ guys do you have any questions based on this things it's only under the home tab Okay, let's guys, do you want any time to think or do you want any time to try? Okay, let's move to the next option. It's pure tables. Okay, I will copy the same values back.